When you start Bootstrap Studio, you are greeted with this start screen. Here is a list of designs you've worked on recently. Each has a title, the date when you last opened it, and the path where the design file is located on your computer. You can think of this list as shortcuts that make opening a design quicker. Removing a design like this only clears the shortcut. The design file itself remains stored on your computer, and you can open it at any time. If I right-click a design and choose Show in Folder, Bootstrap Studio will display the folder where it is stored. You can see that all three of our designs are stored here, even though we just removed one from Recents. Each design you create in Bootstrap Studio is saved as a file with the BS Design extension on your computer. Remember to keep these files safe. If you need to move them between computers, you can email them, copy them to a flash drive, or use an app like Dropbox or Google Drive. To open a file, click the BS Design file here, or the shortcut in the start screen. When you have a design loaded, you can see the full Bootstrap Studio window. At the top is the title bar. Here you will find the application menu and buttons for common actions like creating, opening and saving designs, and changing application settings. On the Mac OS version of Bootstrap Studio, this area is a bit different since the menu is handled by the operating system. Apart from this, the rest of the app is identical. On the right side of the title bar are buttons for exporting, previewing, and publishing your design. We will get back to them later in the series. Clicking the window title opens the command palette. Here you can access common actions by typing. We will cover this in a future video. Lastly, you can see these three buttons. They control the side panels. You can collapse them to free up space and expand them. The panels can also be resized manually like this. You can also rearrange the tabs, move them across, or stack them in groups. At any time, you can press the Reset Panels option in the View menu to go back to the initial layout. If you prefer to change the Bootstrap Studio window to a light theme, you can do it by opening the Settings screen and switching to the Interface section. Here you also have a few usability options, like making the scroll bars thicker. You can also scale the entire window up or down from the View menu. Just click one of the options here, or use the keyboard shortcuts like this. This is your main work area. We call it the stage. This is where you drop components and assemble your design. You can resize it freely, or switch it to a specific breakpoint from these buttons. You can think of breakpoints like device categories. Smartphones, tablets, laptops, and large displays. We will cover these in detail when we discuss responsive web design in our next videos. This is the component panel. All components are organized in groups, and you can also search from here. The online tab is where users share components that they've made. You can install them, and they will show up in the downloads folder here. If you wish to organize your components for quicker access, you can right-click and add to favorites. A new favorites group will appear at the top. To use a component in your design, grab it and drop it on the stage. You can also drop in the overview for better precision. You select a component by clicking it. This gives it a blue outline and a bar with quick actions. From here, you can grab, edit, duplicate, delete, and more. All this will be covered in our next lesson. When a component is selected, you can customize it from the Settings panel on the right. The Appearance tab is where you can modify the component's CSS visually. Options is where you will find various settings that modify the component. Lastly, animation is where you can create animation effects on scroll, page load, or mouse hover. This is the design panel. Here you see the pages, images, CSS, and other assets in your project. If you have multiple pages, you can switch between them by double-clicking here or by switching from the page drop-down here. Something to keep in mind is that although Bootstrap Studio shows these resources as separate files, they are all bundled together in the BS Design file when you save. This way, your project is a single file on your computer, but may contain many different assets inside it. This is the theme panel. Here you can override various properties of your design like colors, fonts, and sizes. This allows you to make easy customizations to your theme from a single place. We will cover it later. And finally, we have the editor panel. Here you can see the HTML of the page you've assembled. You can add class names and attributes to the selected element from this panel. This is the styles editor. It shows the CSS that affects the element. You can also write your code here. When you double-click one of the assets, it is opened as a tab. You can switch between them and rearrange them. When you click here, the entire editor panel is detached and can be placed on a second monitor. This concludes our first look at Bootstrap Studio. Watch our next video to learn how to build your first design.